Championship, though. Mark Kimber led it coming into this event as the green flag goes. On drop scores, he had 171 points. Ollie Caldwell had 164 points. So Ollie, 7 points behind Mark Kimber. Now, in the first heat, as you can see the grid on your screens, Mark Kimber was second and Ollie Caldwell was 11th. So going in Mark Kimber's favour at the moment. In second in the championship on drop scores is Glenn Van Berlo. So Ollie Caldwell is actually third on drops. Well, in fact, I'm getting this all wrong. Mark Kimber is second. Glenn Van Berlo third. Ollie Caldwell is fourth. They're split by just 7 points. So it's 4 points from Kimber to Van Berlo and then 3 points from Van Berlo to Caldwell. That's the situation. Well, that's how it was coming into the event. It will, of course, change as the weekend goes on. And then at the end of the weekend, we'll have to work it out with drop scores as well. But I'll do my best to keep on top of it. As you can see, Adam Smalley just goes through shot. There's Killian Meyer now in shot. That's Mark Kimber, who will start on pole. And Dylan Byers there, who will start alongside. This is the second of two warm-up laps. We should go racing at the end of this lap. And usually it's around two corners time where Mark Kimber will start to slow the pace down. It was at this exact point last time. And well, not on where you are on the screens, where Mark Kimber is now. I'm sure we'll pick him up any second. Just all the carts there filtering through the shot. But there's Mark Kimber now. Now he starts to slow the pace down. Dylan Byers will pull alongside. And in around 30 to 40 seconds, we should go racing for 8 laps. Junior Max heat number 2. So the first win, the win in the first, he went to Dylan Byers with Mark Kimber second and Killian Meyer third. If you're joining us on the live stream, thank you very much for joining us for the last round of the 2016 Rotax Max Euro Challenge here at the Salbris circuit in France. This is heat number 2. Mark Kimber for Strawberry Racing is on pole position. He's the number 7. Alongside him is the 74. That's Dylan Byers. So Kimber will be to the left of your picture. Byers to the right of your picture. Will we get away first time? Yes, we do. And Kimber has got the better of the starts. Dylan Byers tries to go around the outside. But as he did in the first heat, Enzo Valent has gone through to second. Third place then is Byers. Well, someone's trying to challenge Byers in fourth place. Everyone has got through safely this time. So Dylan Byers, I think, may have dropped another place. That might have been Lucas Dunner challenging him. Kimber certainly leads, and we've got a change for second, have we? Coming down the long straight there. No, I think Byers is back to third place. We've got, so it's Valent, Byers, Dunner all battling with each other. We're side by side then going towards the far right-hander. Who's going to come out on top? As they exit the corner, you can see Kimber is leading and away. The two leaders, in fact, are away. So Byers then back to fourth place. They now head down towards the left-hand hairpin. Through they go. Oh, and a change for third then. So Dylan Byers back into third place. It's Enzo Valent in second. Mark Kimber leads. Lucas Dunner is in fourth place as they head up towards the line. Kimber, Valent, Byers, Nomblo, Dunner, Meyer, Phillips, Bergmeier, Morin, and Leppa the top 10. Oh, and a change for fourth place. Well, that was Lucas Dunner trying to go from fifth to third, and unsurprisingly, it hasn't ended very well. Now, Killian Meyer, I think, has been caught up in an incident. Now, was that with Lucas Dunner? We can see the two carts on circuit. That's the number 14. Which is Lucas Dunner, as we suspected. So Killian Meyer and Lucas Dunner. Well, Killian Meyer gets going again. Lucas Dunner, I can tell you, will not go any further in this race. And, well, he was trying quite an ambitious move in the first place. Didn't end too well. But up at the front, you can see Kimber still leads Valent. Valent closing him in. Byers is in third. Fourth place then is Jean Nomblo. Fifth place is the number 21, which I think is Hannes Morin. He started the last lap in ninth place. Let's get the order as they cross the line. Kimber, Valent, Byers, Nomblo, Morin, Bergmeier, Phillips, Lepper, Percival, Phil Doer. Joe Phillips goes up the inside into turn number two. Joe Phillips through to sixth place, passes to Mino Bergmeier and takes Laurie Lepper with him. So Joe Phillips up a place. Oh, and in fact, that was Lepper making the move now. So they changed already. Lepper now is seventh place as they head down towards turn number five. Kimber still leading, but the top three getting closer and closer. Valence was 0.4 behind at the end of the last lap. And Dylan Byers was a second behind the leader, but I can see those gaps getting being reduced when they cross the line next time. Fourth place then is Nonblow, then it's Hannes Morin, then it's Joe Phillips who's charging up at the moment. Then it's Lepper. Behind Lepper, we have Tamino Bergmeier. So what's the gap there between the two leaders? Look at Dylan Byers. He's right on the back of Enzo Valente. Will he make a move into turn two? There he goes up the inside. So a move then from Dylan Byers into second place. This is pretty much the situation we had in the first race with Dylan Byers trying to chase Mark Kimber down. On that occasion, he was able to chase Kimber down and pass him on the last lap. Will he be able to do that this time? Gap is around half a second. Top five then, pretty much all together. Well, I say all together, there's around 1.6 seconds between them, which isn't a lot at all. Hannes Morin is at the back. The fastest lap at the moment is with Dylan Byers. Oh, there's an incident further back down the order. You probably didn't see it on your screens, but two drivers making contact and both get going again. We'll try and update you with who they were. But Mark Kimber makes his way up towards the last corner to complete half race distance. His lead is going to be reduced because Dylan Byers is absolutely flying. Well, it's come down to 3.5 tenths and Dylan Byers sets a new fastest lap, 63.5 seconds. You know the top five, sixth place is Phillips, then it's Lepper, Bergmeier, Percival, Claude, Leone Claude having an absolutely fantastic race. She's up to 10th place. She's made 10 places so far, so trying to recover from what was a bad first race. Change for third place then. That was a move for third place there. That was Jean Nomblo going up the inside. Hannes Morin is now right with them as they head up towards the right-hander. Oh, and that's, I think that's Valence coming back at Nomblo as they make their way down towards the back straight. So Valence back in third place, but for how long? Nomblo is fourth. There he goes back up the inside and completes the move. Nomblo is back into third. Hannes Morin sitting there watching. The one they've got to be wary of, though, is Joe Phillips because he's getting closer and closer to the lot of them. He is now only half a second behind, and Joe Phillips has set a new fastest lap. We've had someone come off at the penultimate corner. I think that might have been Laurie Lepper. Oh, and Hannes Morin up the inside takes third place. So Hannes Morin from fifth to third. Joe Phillips is now trying to make a place as well. They've got Laurie Lepper with them. So Laurie Lepper, not the driver who came off. Down towards the left-hander then. Drivers defending. Joe Phillips trying to go on the attack as they head down towards the far part of the circuit. Then they'll head back towards the start-finish line. But before that, they've got three more corners. We've had a change for lead. Dylan Byers has taken the lead from Mark Kimber. It's quite hard to know where to watch in this one. There's so much action going on that I missed a lead change. But Dylan Byers now leads. Mark Kimber second. That change came on that last lap as the viewers on the live stream would have saw. But will Kimber come back at him into turn number two? No. Kimber not going up the inside, but there was a move. Joe Phillips made a pass on Jean Nomblo. Jean Nomblo comes back and retakes the place at turn three. And now Phillips loses a place to Laurie Lepper, who goes through to seventh. Leonie Claude is chasing a lot of them down. And up the field, we still have our two leaders right together. Oh, and you can see some more defending going on. But there's our two leaders on screen then, heading towards the far part of the circuit. They're going to take the last lap board next time round. And Dylan Byers, at the moment, looks like he's got maybe just enough of a lead. But Mark Kimber will no doubt get a good toe coming down the start finish straight into the left hand, then down towards the last corner. Further back, Joe Phillips has made a pass on Laurie Lepper. But what about our two leaders? Who's going to win the race? It's 1-0 to Dylan Byes in terms of the heat so far. But can Mark Kimber make it 1-0? They head up towards turn number two. Mark Kimber's going to go for the outside. Dylan Byes defends. Mark Kimber tries to get the cut back. They're side by side into turn three. Mark Kimber now trying to go around the outside. He's going to get a toe down the long straight. Can he make a move into turn number five? We should get it up on our static camera. There's the static camera. Mark Kimber trying to go up the inside. He's going to have to go back across. In the background, more battling going on. Lepper is trying to defend from Claude, who's gone past Joe Phillips. But who's going to take the win in this race? Well, Mark Kimber goes to the outside once again. Only half a lap. Not even that for Dylan Byes to hold on. Kimber's going to have two more corners when they exit this left-hander. So two corners to try and make the move. He's going to maybe try the inside. Is he into the left-hand hairpin? No, so he's got one more corner to do it. He doesn't look close enough to me. The win is going to go to Dylan Byes. Second is going to be Mark Kimber. Third is going to be Hannes Morin. So the win then. Two wins out of two for Dylan Byes. Second place. Two second place finishes for Mark Kimber. Third is Hannes Morin. Enzo Valente finishes fourth. Jean Nomblo finishes in fifth. Laurie Lepper is sixth. Well, and how about that? Leonie Claude gains 13 places to finish seventh. That is an absolutely fantastic drive from the young French lady. She finishes in seventh. Joe Phillips is eighth. Tamino Bergmeier is ninth. And it's Ollie Caldwell in 10th place. Phil Doer is 11th. Antoine Percival is 12th. Malizia is 13th. Laszlo Toth, once again, he gained 12 places this time. He gained 10 places in the first heat. He finishes in 14th place. Artsemi is 15th. Zhong is in 16th place. You can see them first to 12th on your screen. There's 13th through to 24th. Yassin Ferrati, 17th. And it was Conor McCarthy, Adam Smalley, Ryan McDermott, Clement Theobald, Hugo Anderson, Andre Walter, Pepin Klejeveld was 24th. And we lost, unfortunately, Killian Meyer and Lucas Dunner on, well, seven laps ago. It was on the second lap, I believe it happened. The fastest lap went to Ryan McDermott in the end. He may have finished in 20th place, but he set the fastest lap, 63.3. So maybe he's found